most of us think that we get enough sleep. Majority of times it's wrong. In fact, most of our patients is, especially since I do wellness, most of the patients who come inside and they wonder why I give them basically melatonin. Majority of times we don't understand a simple sentence called circadian rhythm. Circadian rhythm is actually, your body's natural, basically we are saying it's day or night, right? Now, the entire sleep pattern basically, it gets distorted when people basically think they get sufficient amount of sleep. Now, insufficient amount of sleep will lead to a lot of things, hypertension, diabetes, depression, making things worse. Then they go on to basically taking a sleeping tablet to sit and basically try to correct the sleep disorders. Now, most people think that when they get 3 to 4 hours of sleep and they work the next day, they think that they're great, they're like Superman. But this inevitably basically causes them to become worse off. Now, circadian rhythm is basically the most important basically rhythm for sleep. Now, if a person doesn't have sufficient amount of sunlight during the daytime, the body doesn't understand whether it's night or day. When it doesn't understand it's night or day, the body starts taking basically the daytime as basically night and the nighttime as day. There is a particular hormone being released by the pineal gland in the brain. It's called melatonin. Now, melatonin levels starts falling down as you basically grow older. But in a younger person, when melatonin levels starts to drop, sleep disturbance becomes, the sleep disturbance pattern becomes basically more obvious. And he goes into basically insomnia. Now, again, insomnia is another thing as well. A lot of people think that insomnia is basically trouble falling asleep. It's actually, insomnia places multiple modes of basically how insomnia takes place. Patterns that basically the people don't follow, sleep that basically they underestimate, and they themselves basically induce basically delayed rhythm of sleep patterns. Now, those people who smoke will actually cause a lot of problems. Generally, if you're a heavy smoker, sleep is going to be a main complication, because what will happen is the body will actually start waking up earlier at night and ask and demand for nicotine. And if you don't give it sufficient amount of nicotine, other complications take place. Headaches, migraines, constipation, they all take place. Now, if you don't sleep as well, the body is unable to process what you've learned the whole day. So if you see a child can sleep to 16 hours or 20 hours a day. And that's what the child is actually understanding and basically making information available to him. Now, we learn the whole day, even though we say we're old, we learn the whole day, and we process those thoughts at night. Now, if we don't have sufficient sleep, we are unable to focus the next day. And that's why people who basically go through stress are unable to focus the next day, because they don't actually get sleep. So, getting sleep, how do you actually get sleep? My first suggestion would be exposing yourself to sunlight, because that will actually sit on and trigger off metabolism of the body, like vitamin D. Now, vitamin D is also very important. If you don't have sufficient amount of vitamin D, the body cannot sleep well as well. Now, vitamin D actually helps calcium to suddenly be absorbed in the body. Now, if you don't see sufficient sunlight, you will not know basically that it's day, and then eventually you will know it's night. So, by exposing yourself to early morning sun rays, or basically having a brisk walk in the morning, or in a small having a tea by our famous mama shops, then you don't have sufficient amount of sunlight, and then this will actually contribute to basically other problems. Another thing is actually getting a ritual done. Now, most people who say I can't get sleep, so because the body doesn't understand that it's time to sleep, so it's looking or it's basically waiting for something to tell you to go to bed. So we're doing a ritual. What is a ritual? Combing your hair, having a bath, getting yourself to read a small book before you sit on and turn in. That all basically tells the body it is time for you to sleep. So the body thinks, then it goes to sleep. And this is actually what we're trying to get a rhythm in. Now, if you can get that settled in, majority of times sleep is basically settled. Alright? Then comes to the next thing, what can you do? Well, my wife was the one that first told me, said, why do you have a large screen TV in your bedroom? And I turned around and said, no, it's so much easier for me to do my work. Now, I'm advising you now. This is advice given by my wife, and I'm advising you that if you sit down and actually have some electronic item, especially your iPhones, which are the biggest problem now, obviously smartphones, they actually sit down and stimulate you and don't allow you to sleep. And if you still watch basically a movie Or even if you have a digital clock that blinks, they all will actually trigger off difficulties in you to fall asleep. Getting it off. Your body has its own clock. It will sit down, and if you put in basically the same amount of time, it will wake up every day. Until today, I don't use an alarm clock to wake up. No matter it's a Sunday or Monday, I still wake up at 7 o'clock. Now, again, don't quote me because this, you can edit it later. Don't quote me why I don't come to work early. Eh? That's got nothing to do with it. Okay? But if you go through basically this, just these two, three rituals, you will actually notice that sleep patterns will improve. The other thing is not to sleep on a very empty stomach. Okay? Most people think that I cannot eat anything late at night is a problem. The body also wakes up because it has insufficient amount of food. Now, when I say basically have something to eat, I'm telling 2 hours later. It doesn't mean go and having char kway teow at 11 o'clock at night and going back to try to sleep at 12 o'clock. That is wrong. Then the body is still full. It's unable to sit and digest that. Indigestion takes place. Another complication takes place. So you should not go to bed hungry. Neither should you go to bed full. So you should have a small light meal 2 hours prior to actually going to bed. And that's how you basically start the next day. Okay? That should be basically few points and pointers to actually sit around and tell you how to go to sleep itself. Other aids that actually can take place would be taking sufficient amount of nutrients, especially during the day. And if you basically have lack amount, if you lack the time to sit and actually expose yourself to sun, adding vitamin D to your diet, and basically taking sufficient amount of calcium, selenium, and this actually lets you sleep properly itself.